Hello and welcome to the show. This is Lockout 2. I'm hoping to change my username to this in the future. Wait, what do I have red in my hair? And I have earrings also. That's quite weird. But today, I think this is, well, wait, what time is it? Well, probably by the time it comes out, it'll be midnight. It has to be midnight. This is going to be a 40-minute video. Today I am playing the Let's Play World. Well, today, I mean, I'll probably not upload this till tomorrow, but this is going to be 40 minutes long. That's my goal. We're going to say you better not be, well, I can't even say what that is that I'm saying it better not be. Yeah, what is it I'm trying to say? Oh well, I give up. Let's see. So, I could probably go along the bottom. Oh no, I can't. Yeah. Let's see. Torch. What I was thinking is, since all the water pushes the crops over here, I think I could use a prospect, not prospect, I think I could use a hopper here. Not entirely sure how that works, but it'd be worth a try. Oh, I think I know how to make it fully automatic. I think I figured it out. Kinda. So, from my knowledge, I think a dispenser can plant down the crops. I'm not fully sure, but I'm pretty sure a dispenser can plant the crops down. Now, when plant the crops down, well, they can grow, but here's the question, can I make it fully automatic? Going to the testing world. You know, I should make a super flat world for testing, shouldn't I? It'd be a lot easier, huh? Well, time for me to make a super flat world for redstone testing. And you guys get to watch me struggle at making a world. Let's see, create new world. You can upload worlds to your realm after you create it. I don't know anything about that, so I'm just gonna go this route. Root route. Multiplayer. I don't know how to do that kind of stuff. Let's see, so game. I cannot type and talk at the same time. Just come on. Okay, perfect. Starting map. Don't need that. Bonus chest. No, it's gonna be creative anyway. Let's continue. Perfect. Shoot, no idea what I want it to be, so I'll just leave it at that. Friendly fire, no idea. Show coordinates, yes. Where is she? Come on. Inventory. Activate cheats, yes. Way. Okay, so cheater on there, I think. Not even 5 minutes here. Let me see. Don't have to worry about any of that, I don't think. So now it's time to create the world. That was my last chance. If I did anything wrong, just to show you how fast it is to load a world on Pog Edition. For me on the PC. Old channel, I've seen it on the PC. That took me about an hour to make. Now that I think of it, it's kind of scary. Wait. Just sprint forward. Come on, I'll find something. Surely we'll find something, right? I think there's villagers on this. Well, if not, well, I'd like to be by one because I could use that. Go faster than this, I feel like. I'm also running out of hooks into the village. Oh wait, did I see something this way? No, I didn't. Come on. I already won 1,000 blocks here. Come on. There's gotta be a village in this. Also, I'm very, very movemental, if that makes any sense. Don't like having traveled this far. I'm starting to lose hope that I'm gonna find a village. Wait. Come on, I'll figure it out. Teleport where? No targets matched selector. So what you're saying is this is villageless land. Not for me, it is. Save and quit. Delete a world. Somewhat sad. But I obviously failed at making it. Okay. Wait, there's gotta be. I guess there's no way of, well, I'm getting a village in this world. So I'm gonna do a little bit of no one at, oh, I didn't make that time either. There is it with me, okay. Wait, what if I just go across? Wait. Okay, I'm gonna use slash. A-N-L. Killed, left out, zip 1, 2, 3, 4. Still here, aren't I? Yeah. Okay, well, this is the second way you can die in this game. Maybe not if you're on a server, but for me, this is one way. Okay, but honestly, you can survive forever just by doing after some. Oh, that's cute, I'm not gonna kill this guy. Basically, you can go after a sheep or something. Okay, wait. good sheep right here. That's a cute horse. This is what you do when you want to kill something in a super flat world that doesn't have villages. You just have to spam messages. Oh, I feel bad now. Oh well. But I'm gonna go back into creative mode. Okay. This is turning into a testing. Okay. Settings. Wait. Quick survival. Oh. Crying out loud. I feel like that would be enough. I'll get high enough. I will get very high. I'll be right back. So, when you're not high enough in the world, you just fly up 5 minutes. I just wasted the last 5 minutes of my life going up to 1,111. Hello. Survival. Raging game. Eat a notch apple. Eat. Come on, I'm not gonna die here. What's your guess? Am I gonna die or not? I'm getting close. I feel like I am gonna die. Ah. Well, that was close. So, this is the spawn right here. 0-0. Alright. I have already tried dispensers and droppers don't work for this neither. That's disappointing. Well, that's another. Another idea is. Once I got this out, wait. I need chest. Normal chest. Okay, I don't think I need any levers. First things first, figure out how to make a stupidly big. What are these called? Wait, can't I place it down? Thank you. Okay, so, boom. Boom. Okay, this is fairly easy. Make a nice big chest. Okay, and then I place down these. Now for the egg farm I'm gonna create, I don't think this is big enough. I don't know, I'll find out in a minute, right? Trial and error. Is what Minecraft's all about, I guess. Let's see. Looks completely stupid. Let's see. But that's fine. Okay, so, I probably should. Go up. No way, I gotta go up one more. Like that. This is how you make a chicken farm. No one asked me how, but that's okay. I'm just gonna make it anyway, because I'm curious how crazy I can make this. And, find out how stupid I am at, redstone. That's also another reason why I'm doing this. Instead of dirt, why don't I use glass? Yeah, good enough. Okay. I am so used to having to worry about how long the video is, but it could be 5 hours long and doesn't matter anymore. I'll make the third layer. Why the heck not? I'm in creative mode, let's see. Okay. get Griffith, dude. It's like an egg. I didn't even know that existed. Well, I do, but I don't. Is that a good thing? Hey, how many of these can I fit in here and do for it? That would be ground beans for something. What a few. I'm not lagging yet, so I'll just keep going. This farm's gonna be OP, I can tell you that. I think OP means overpowered. So in theory, you need about... if you're on a server, or anything, try to fix this where no one lives, or they're gonna hate you. I guess there's no one to be cramming, huh? Is that creeper over there? No. Okay, perfect. And yeah, it's pretty laggy, I guess. No one pooped out an egg, but it will happen. If I just got all the chicken now. If I had all the chicken out, that would be complete chaos, and I would be in huge trouble. The only way I know how to kill these is with a sword or a lava. Let's just type up the wrong one again. And yeah, I'm not gonna even attempt to put more inside there. Just put the glass roof on it, and forget about it for a while. I guess this video would be called testing. So far I've made something so laggy, well, it's just laggy. Yes. There should be plenty of eggs coming out, but there's none. Don't tell me I don't know how to make anything. Well, I'll wait a few minutes and try to build the next thing I want to test out. What is those considered? Yes. A zombie farm. Construction? Nature? I don't know, let's see. Of course, oh, I'll make a fancy one this time. Get rid of these fillets. Don't need them anytime soon. Well, actually, I probably could make a little bit of a pathway here. So I don't lose where I made the chicken farm and everything. Well, actually, it's right next to the spawn, but. Okay, so. For the mob farm I usually make, you need to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. Now I'm pretty sure it's 24 blocks. See, I'll grab a villager. Spawn villager. Okay, so what you do for the test here, well I'm ready for the test, not 24, so you're gonna go for 23 blocks maybe. And yes, you're gonna go for 23 blocks. Reason why, you can punch them one, yeah. Now double check this 23 blocks. 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 20, 24. Okay, I'll try again. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 23. So I think it's 23 bucks we're looking for. Well, let's find out in a second. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. So you're looking for 23 higher customized ones here. Once you do that, step 2 is a little bit simpler. Actually, a little bit harder, now that I think of it. So, let's see. So yes, the reason why I'm able to talk about currently is because, you know, everyone's asleep, and... Well, I'm just hoping no one hears me. Basically, is all you have to do, or all I do. Is set up something. Very close to bedrock, I think. Oh well, I think I'll be fine. Set up a storage silo, or not a silo. I'm not trying to copy, I would have to watch Bubble Guppy, but I would have to rewatch Bubble Guppy, Dr. Bubble Guppy's video on how to make a storage silo, because I sort of heck don't remember how. But once you get to this point, you want to go 8 blocks that way. Well, 7, so, because you got the water would end off right there. So you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You do that on all 4 sides. I got all 4 sides done, so then I'm going by 1.12. You don't go 1 block high, because they can swim right out. Well, some of you haven't even updated anyway. The best thing to do is go 2 blocks high before you start the main part. Because you haven't even got the main part done yet. Our part's coming still, but what you're gonna do, you don't have to delete any of these blocks after you're all done using them. By the way, it doesn't matter what block you use, you could use cobblestone, which I use that all the time in survival mode when I try to build these ones, or I end up digging them out of the mountain, which ends up makes them not work properly. Oh, also, I'm gonna show you how to make the most complicated redstone farm like this I have ever made in my Minecraft history. So the problem is, it's gonna take a while, that if I can say so, I say so myself, or whatever the thing's called. It will take a little bit longer than you might want to spend on a farm. So if it takes too long, Well, but basically, you get a dropper, I think it's a dropper or a dispenser. I built this in about a year ago, and what you do with the dropper or dispenser, I don't know which one it was, something to let the water bucket out. However wide the water bucket was, you would make the farm, if that makes any sense. So I don't know exactly how far the water bucket spreads out, but how far it spreads out, I'm not being very good today. How far the water bucket goes out, you will make the top platform. Now you want to make it at least 40 blocks in the air. And it's no little tiny itty bitty haha farm. It's a huge farm. not the best. It could be bigger than what I made. But I think for starters, it's gonna be a pain in the butt. But you can probably build it if you want. If you're a Minecraft pro, you can build it in the first hour. Well, you probably spend 5 hours placing materials, just like I did, but I mean, in theory, it should only take about, I don't know, 5 hours collecting materials. Well, for me, maybe for you pros that are a lot faster at building than me. Yeah, you guys don't have more issues, yeah. But what you do once you build it 40 blocks high and you put a dispenser right where you place the water bucket. So the water doesn't go off the edge. Start explaining it. I will show you a tiny piece of the book because I'm just trying to tell you what it is. So what you do is, let's say, there's the water line. So you just do that. I'll just grab a lever or something. And you just, with the outer, you just outline where the, where to delete the blocks, if that makes any sense. So you only want the platform as wide as the water is. And you can make several platforms. Depends on how much mob loot you actually want. Now, this ain't 40 blocks in air. This ain't gonna be the farm, but you go like that, basically. And then they fall down to their deaths. And then if they don't die, if there's some kind of magical one with armor on, you're gonna have magma blocks, and then you're gonna have water to sell the loot from magma blocks into hoppers. Hoppers are gonna be running to a chest. And yeah. You're gonna turn the water on and off, by the way. You're gonna have three switches, at least I did. And the redstone, I mean, it's somewhat simple. Well, I mean, it took me 7 hours to do the redstone. But, I mean, that's technically simple redstone for most people. What is that stuff floating in the air over there? Oh, that's my screen I'm looking at. Well, not my screen either. That is my... I can figure it out. Well, yes, that is my screen, but I mean... it's dark that I see on my screen. Oh yeah, when you build one of these, you're gonna make it... it's big, like this. So basically, what the theory is, the mobs... I don't know if it is done now. It is I fell into a water pit. Splash. You get down to half a heart, and then you have hoppers right down here. And then the hoppers gonna be running into a chest. It'll be neat.
Yeah, that's basically how the farm works. But, problem is, they're smarter now, so, you're gonna have to have trapdoors also. A few hundred trapdoors, actually. I think trapdoors will make it easier for them to fall in. I have not used trapdoors in it yet, but I'm gonna give it a try. In theory, I think they think the trapdoors are blocks. So they, they technically are blocks, but you can fall through them. So, what they're gonna do is they're gonna walk up to them and fall through the trapdoors. And then you're supposed to get. And then they're gonna fall down to their death, and yeah. They're gonna get their loot. Now, this does take quite a while to build if you can't place blocks with a darn. Which I'm not placing blocks very good neither. So, it's gonna take a while. Now, it might be a good idea to light that area down or up because you might see some things like creeper spawn and blow up in your face because, well, it's a great thing to do, they want hugs. Last one. Okay, let's see. Get all this done. Has your knife. Mine has been all there, I mean, not the best. I made an entire cake, and for my uncle's birthday, I even cooked it myself. And here comes me mom, and I'm just gonna take the little outer shell of the cake, just stuff it stuck in the pan. I thought, oh, go ahead, he won't notice that you took that. That was certainly a mistake of me telling her to go ahead and take it. She ate the entire cake. Literally the entire cake. Not the entire cake, but practically the whole thing. She gets mad when I take a bite of my birthday cake before I eat towards my birthday. Yeah, I thought it was pretty funny. And yes, you want it to be 2 blocks tall because you don't want to have Enderman spawn inside here because, well, when you hit them, they'll teleport out. I don't know what's going on here, but I'm gonna fix that. Yeah, like I told you, the zombies and stuff spawn down there. Yeah, that's how you can tell. Is when you're not even been building it and they're spawning stuff. Come on, I'll get this deal. I mean, it's a 32-minute thing so far. It's taking a little while to make this. And I'm probably now slightly worried that I'm not running out of storage. So that's something that happens for me. Now I got 4. I don't know how I managed to not run out of storage so far. I got 4 GB of storage. That's what my card says. 4 GB. But now, once you have done this, I mean, you're having your typical everything spawn under here. Your spiders, your old fancy zombies here. Wait, I'm curious. Come on, I'll kill you. Ah, well, you're having your old fashioned zombies and everything spawning down here, and your spider. You know, your spiders and everything. But now it comes time to do the roof. Yeah, it's gonna take quite a while to fill in. For me, at least. And, there's no guarantee on how much you're gonna get from this every hour or anything. I can't help you out there. The reason why, and it depends on how you have your area lit up and everything. So if you don't have your house lit up, we're gonna have as if you don't have outside lit up, everything's in the spawn outside. Well, not everything, but I mean, it's in spawn outside. This chest it spawns inside the house, but this is much as spawns inside here. Which I mean, it's not completely ideal. If you know what I mean. I feel like I have to place a torch down, but I don't have to place a torch down to all this is filled in. Let's
See, also, you wanna like the roof up, probably. Just for a little bit more efficiency, so nothing spawns on top of there. Or you put a carpet there, and then you don't have to worry about enderman spawning. But I actually think, well, actually, oh, enderman don't teleport on carpet. What I mean is, no, maybe they do. Now I think of it. I'm Minecraft bro to the max, I gotta say. I'm only feeling in the deep space, Now, many YouTubers have done this, but they haven't done exactly how I'm gonna do it, and I recommend putting several layers on, because it might be a little bit better. I'm gonna show you why. Well, I'm not even gonna show you why. The reason why it's gonna be faster is because it's more layers and more spawning spaces. And if you get good luck, well, you're gonna have all the zombies and all that spawn on both layers, and that might increase your chances. At least it's in my theory. So now that you, when you get this done, go look around on the roof, placing all the blocks in at a million miles an hour. You're bound to get one or two of them messed up. But that's just the thing that happened. It's a part of life. Now I'm gonna do this as far as some fashion. I mean, you need some fanciness. What neatness in your life? I mean, do you want to look pretty or okay? I'll pick the pretty. Yeah, this is not something you have to do here. It's just if you want, if you're gonna be looking at it all the time, like you probably should just try to spruce it up. Also, there's nothing down here spawning anymore. Not something. Is the chicken farm close enough? And that's why you make a big chicken farm. To laugh your head off so much, you die. I'm just kidding. I don't want to kill all you. But yes, it will take your frames down very, very low. Now what you're going to do is grab yourself some torches. Here, or, oh, there we go. You don't need dispensers, if you click, there we go. Just walk around here casually and place down torches. Yeah, seems good right there. Oh, let me come over here. There we go. Okay. Now you need to take all the stuff. Your hopper, go right there. So, you want to aim them. Let's say you want to chest. Okay, so then you're gonna place a chest, if I'm correct. Right. Here. Perfect. Now. Okay, that worried me. That's worrisome. Wait. Villager. I might be doing this wrong here. Let's find out. Wait. Is this?
Slow down. Well, I will just go for the standard zombie. Z-A-M. Not the zombie. Are you serious? So, turns out, villagers have more freaking health. Well, that's a trip. Let's see. Wait, how long has this been? Is it over an hour? 40 minutes. I'm doing good on time, at least. So, well, what you're gonna do here... Well, let's take it over to here. You don't need that big of a storage silo for this, because it's not... When I say it's not most efficient, I mean it's not the most efficient. Okay, so... perfect. Now you're gonna wanna dig out under these hoppers here. Wait, so here on how... Well, actually, I shouldn't have the chest that far away. Maybe right there would be fine. So, you're gonna dig out under. Just like so. I mean, don't be scared of... Well, you can if you're just having fun. Here in Mystic Survival, I don't think so. If I'm correct, I can just punch you. I'm confused now. Wait. So, in that case, what if I go like that? I'll get back to you guys in a second. Okay, so it has to be two punches to kill, apparently. Okay, whatever. Huh. Don't fully understand why. Also, this is not the ideal punching height, I don't think. I think it should be... up like this. Okay. The reason why it should be up like this is because... Oh, I tried to put trap doors in and it's working perfectly. Oh, never mind. Yeah, I'm not going to put trap doors in. No reason to. Let's see. Now, I do think a whole lot of YouTubers have seen this several times on different channels. I think pretty much everyone knows how to make this, sadly. So once you do that, I'm gonna use check the chicken farm real quick. Go into the laggiest place on earth. Just casually. Have you filled the whole chest up yet? No. That's okay though. You don't really need the full chest. At least I hope you don't. And, yeah, this is pretty much done now. You can give yourself some protection walls, per se. You know, just some little stuff like this. But that's only if you need to. Or if you're planning on AFK over here. This is what you want to do. For me, you don't have to build walls. But I am a... Well, actually I do, because I'm a security cat when it comes to stuff like this. I feel like it's thunderstorm, but it's not. Okay, so once you get all of this done, easiest place in the roof. Okay, just like that. Two places in the roof. Building a house around the mob spawn is actually not that bad of an idea. Because if you put it so it falls into your roof, what you can do is, you can get your self enchantment table in the same place where you got your mob spawner. Where's the middle? I don't know, I'll pick any place. Good enough. So you wanna just walk around here, put some of these in here. Just off the door then. Don't need a chest, just need a door. CDR. I'll just put standard in. Why not? That's not pretty. There we go, that's right. Now, time for me to go over here and not go in creative yet, but go in survival yet. Actually, we're going one step to the farm. Add slabs at the wazoo. So what you're gonna do is just place slabs everywhere possible. Ooh, good, I've reached my limit of 40 minutes. Well, not limit. 20 if that was the limit of uploading. I think I can upload 10 hours if I want currently. I don't want to wait 10 hours, but I'm pretty sure I can upload that long. I don't want to make a 10-hour video, but I mean, because I have time, I don't have time to do that. First of all, because I have a life, you know, everyone has a life, at least I hope everyone does. If not, shut this video off now and go get yourself a life. Because, I mean, if you don't have a life and you're sitting here watching a kid play Minecraft, I feel bad for you if you actually are a person just sitting here, nothing to do, so you don't have a life and just watching me play Minecraft. I feel bad for people who actually are doing that. So now, you want to fill in the roof. Now this one will take a little longer. Yeah, I'm putting the roof on. But this is to make sure nothing, I repeat, nothing possible spawns. And I mean, a slime could spawn when you have torches, I think. Actually, yes, they can spawn. I have had them spawn before. The worst part is I couldn't find a slime chunk, even though they were spawning for me. Let's see, yeah, I'm just gonna place in everything possible. As many slabs. Now, you don't want to have double slabs, because they can spawn on those, so that's technically a full block. And you don't want that. You want them to die, or not die. You want them to be unable to spawn here, which making a single layer of slabs actually makes it impossible for them to spawn. At least as far as I can tell. And yeah, this is a fairly good way. Now, I've never done it like this, I repeat, I've never done it like this, I just am going by a bunch of different farms. Okay, Iskall, Etho, welcome to Foodcraft Guy, new Foodcraft Guy, I think, his YouTube name is Etho. I mean, there's a bunch of new Foodcraft people, but I mean, his YouTube name's Etho, and
most people know him for his, astonishing Let's Play. And I don't watch his Let's Play that much. Why do I watch it that much? Well, I mean, I just get overwhelmed because I can't really watch every video of his Let's Play. Because he has 500, 600 episodes of it, and you know how it is probably, I hope you do.
Bah! If I was in, survival, then well, that'd be my death.
But, sir, luckily I'm not in survival.
And, yeah, I don't have to worry about dying.
Instead, I have to worry about falling out of the world, because that's actually possible, and if I fall out of the world, I die. So I actually do have to worry about dying, even creative mode. Huh. Never really thought of that. That's a weird death. Oh, by the way, actually, you are able to survive. Well, at least in 1.11.2. You were able to survive in being in the void forever if you were continuously chewing on notch apples. I did this experiment in 2016. I don't know if it still works, but technically you could live in the void if you wanted. You just have to have infinity notch apples. In my case, I ate them until I ran out of the stock of 64. Oh, this take forever. So bad for y'all. You have to watch me, do this. Oh dear. Come on, don't make checkerboard. I'll pick that up in a second.
It'd be funny if one mob somehow spawned on here
and proved me wrong. That would just...
I'm not saying I'm wrong, I don't think I am, but I mean... If a zombie or something spawned on here... that would not be hilarious. But, you know, you might as well check out what your work's doing. One spider is in here, but that's okay. I think that's okay. Oops, don't place them all back. 52 minutes. I'm running out of time. Guys, I'm just gonna kill all these off here and I'll find out how much XP I get. Okay. I get much goodness. Yes, I did. Didn't get much XP though. I don't think so. So guys, see you guys next time. This is practically an hour long video. I didn't get a full chest worth of this goodness though. That's very bad lag. Sorry. See you guys next time. Don't die and bye.